Hi, this video is about how to calibrate the Odyssey's pitch and scaling. The procedure is from the original Arp Odyssey service manual and is the same for all Arp, Korg and Behringer Odysseys. The trim pots will, however, have different names depending on who's the manufacturer. In this video, I've used the Behringer Odyssey, and therefore I'll be using the Behringer names, but also show the Arp names on the screen. It would be a good idea to check the voltages in the power supply first, otherwise you will have a really hard time calibrating. The internal voltages in Odyssey has to be exactly plus and minus 15.00 volts. I made a video on how to open up the Behringer and adjust the voltages. There's a link at the top of the screen, and I'll leave a link in the description. First, set all the Odyssey's front panel sliders at the minimum positions. Then set the VCF frequency and the VCA gain at the maximum positions. Set the VCO1 waveform to square wave. Set the VCO1 volume to max in the audio mixer. Put the VCO1 range switch in the keyboard on position. Put the VCO2 sync switch in the off position. Make sure that the transpose switch is in the normal position. Monitor the output of the Odyssey with a frequency counter, like an oscilloscope or a multimeter. This first step is just to check that the VCOs are approximately at the correct value at low frequencies. Put the VCO1 core slider down fully. Put the VCO1 fine-tune slider exactly in the middle. Press the lowest C on the keyboard. Your frequency counter should read 20 Hz. If it's far off, you have to open up the synth and adjust the VCO1 offset trimmer to get 20 Hz. Mine was good, so I didn't have to do that. With the lowest key on the keyboard still sounding, adjust the VCO1 coarse frequency slider for exactly 100 Hz on the frequency counter. Press the highest C on the keyboard. Turn the VCO1 scale trimmer to adjust the frequency to exactly 800 Hz. Use a small screwdriver. Repeat the calibration process until you measure exactly 100 Hz on lowest C and 800 Hz on highest C. Mine was bang on at the first go, but I found that it usually takes several attempts before it's perfect. When the scaling for the first oscillator is perfect, repeat the process for the VCO2. I prefer to do it by ear with both the VCO1 and 2 at the maximum volume in the audio mixer. Set the VCO2 waveform to square wave. Press the lowest C on the keyboard. Raise the volume of VCO2. You can now hear both the oscillators. Adjust the VCO2 coarse frequency slider for exactly 100 Hz. And press the highest C on the keyboard. Using the VCO2 scale trimmer to adjust the frequency to exactly 800 Hz. Go back and forth until you have a perfect 100 to 800 Hz interval. Next, make sure that no patch cables are attached to the CV gate and trig jacks, and that the Odyssey is working in duophonic mode. Set the VCO1 to minimum volume and VCO2 to maximum volume in the audio mixer. If you duophonically play two notes on the keyboard, only the highest note will sound. Press and hold the highest C down on the keyboard, Then press and release the lowest C, still holding the highest C down. There should be no change in pitch of the VCO2 when the lowest note is pressed. Adjust the VCO2 scale 2 tremor until there's no change in pitch when the lowest note is pressed. And that's it. Now your Odyssey should play in pitch all over the keyboard, and we are done.